Our stress and dietary choices can cause liver cancer. If you fix these things, you may have a higher chance of reversing liver cancer. In this video, you're going to learn about the purpose of the liver. After that, I'm going to talk about liver cancer and why we get it. So let's start. The liver is the largest internal organ that sits on the right side of the belly. It weighs about 3 pounds and has a reddish-brown color. The liver's main job is to filter the blood coming from the digestive tract before passing it to the rest of the body. The liver makes many of the chemicals required by the body to function well. It also manufactures cholesterol and triglycerides. Another function of this organ is to convert glucose in carbohydrates into glycogen. The liver also stocks vitamins and chemicals that the body needs. Hepatocytes are the primary cells of the liver. They are responsible for making many of the proteins in the body. These cells also play a vital role in your metabolism and detoxification. The liver also makes bile. Bile is a greenish-brown liquid primarily made of cholesterol, bile salts, and bilirubin. It aids digestion by breaking down fats into fatty acids that the digestive tract can absorb. The gallbladder is a small pouch that sits just under the liver. It stores bile produced by the liver. The gallbladder is about the size of a small pear and is full of bile before you eat. It squeezes stored bile into the small intestine through a series of tubes called ducts. After meals, the gallbladder is empty and flat, like a deflated balloon. So now that you know what the liver does, let's explore what liver cancer is. Liver cancer begins in the cells of your liver. Several types of cancer can form in the liver. Primary liver cancer, which starts in the liver, accounts for about 2% of the cancers in the US. The most common type of liver cancer is hepatocellular carcinoma. It begins in hepatocyte cells, the primary liver cell. Other liver cancers form in the bile ducts. Most people don't have signs or symptoms in the early stages of primary liver cancer. When signs and symptoms do appear, they may include losing weight without trying, loss of appetite, upper abdominal pain, nausea and vomiting, general weakness and fatigue, abdominal swelling, yellow discoloration of your skin and the whites of your eyes, and white chalky stools. So let's learn the real cause of liver cancer. One of the reasons why we get cancer is because of stress and emotional trauma. How one reacts to stress appears to be a major factor in the development of cancer. Suppressed anger is the most common trait in cancer patients. Cancer patients often felt rejected by one or both parents. Therefore, they have a tremendous need for approval and acceptance. Because of their emotional wounds, they are more sensitive to stress. Our thoughts and emotions have a powerful effect on our health. Everything in the universe is energy vibrating at different frequencies. Even our thoughts and emotions have certain frequencies. That is why they can alter the body, which is also energy. The German doctor Reinhard Hammer found the link between our emotional trauma and cancer. He worked at a cancer clinic in Munich in Germany. Therefore, he could ask cancer patients questions about their emotional ordeal. All his patients experienced different unexpected conflict shocks before their cancer diagnosis. Dr. Hammer obtained brain scans of all his cancer patients. He discovered that different areas of the brain control various organs and glands. Every cancer has a distinct conflict shock. A conflict shock is a traumatic experience that we couldn't expect. When we experience emotional trauma, it activates a particular biological program. A biological program helps the organ resolve the conflict. Animals also suffer from biological conflict. They experience them when someone attacks them or they lose their territory. Our body can't see the difference between a thought and a real situation. Therefore, these programs may activate when you think about a problem. The subconscious mind analyzes the situation and then decides what program to run. The symptoms reveal how it deciphers the situation. Our past experiences, social conditioning, values, and beliefs affect the interpretation. At the moment of the trauma, the conflict shock impacts a specific predetermined area in the brain. On a brain CT scan, you can see the impact visible as concentric rings. German new medicine calls them Heimerhertz. Heimer also learned that diseases run in two phases. We have the active conflict phase that activates the moment we have the shock. And at the moment we resolve that conflict, we enter the healing stage. So this is what Heimer discovered about liver cancer. I'll first talk about hepatocellular carcinoma, and then I'm going to talk about cancer in the bile ducts. Hepatocellular carcinoma starts in the liver parenchyma. The liver parenchyma forms the bulk of the liver. It consists of hepatocytes, which are the prime functional cells of the liver. The biological conflict linked to the liver parenchyma is a starvation conflict. A person can suffer a starvation conflict when there is a lack of food. You can also experience this shock when you're on a restrictive diet and can't eat your favorite food. Another reason for this trauma can be because of a colon cancer diagnosis. You might be afraid of not being able to eat if you have this kind of cancer. Other reasons for this biological program can also be when you wear a colostomy bag, lose your appetite, or experience excessive vomiting during chemo. A threat of starvation could also be because of not being able to make ends meet. For example, it can be because of being fired from your job, pay cuts, the loss of a business, bankruptcy, loss of clients, an unexpected rent increase, a devastating divorce that takes you to the cleaners, when someone confiscates your property, the loss of savings, financial debts, or losing a family member who provided financial support. The conflict shock has to do with the distress of not having resources to feed oneself or others. During the conflict active phase, liver cells grow to the intensity of the conflict. The biological purpose of the cell increase is to improve the function of the liver. In this way, it can digest food better. Liver nodules develop as a result of the continuing cell growth. After the conflict resolution, fungi or bacteria remove the cells no longer needed. Healing symptoms may include pain due to the swelling of the liver and night sweats. Cancer can also form in the bile ducts. The bile ducts branch through the liver and join the gallbladder to form the common bile duct. The biological conflict linked to the bile duct is a male territorial anger conflict. It can also be a female identity conflict. A territorial anger conflict means the anger you feel in your domain. It can be literal or symbolic. Typical territorial anger conflicts are disputes at home, feuds at the workplace, daycare, playground, nursing home or hospital, an attack at one's village, town or country, battles over land or property, annoying noise in the house or neighborhood, a fight over a parking place or a toy are other examples of territorial anger conflicts. A female identity conflict means the inability to establish one's position or place. This conflict can be both real or imagined. Typical examples of an identity conflict include an unwanted move, change of school or workplace, feeling unsettled, not knowing where to belong, not finding one's place in a relationship within the family, the group at work, or in the culture and society at large, and discrimination against one's belief or sexual orientation. This conflict is a decision struggle or not knowing what choice to make or where to go. The biological purpose of the program in the bile ducts is to widen them. This process leads to better digestion and more energy to resolve the conflict. Healing symptoms are swelling due to fluid accumulation and abdominal pain. Another reason for liver cancer can be because of gallstones. Your body encloses poisons in cholesterol and stores it in the liver duct as gallstones. If it didn't do that, then these toxins would cause bigger problems. While these stones protect you from a big disaster, they also obstruct the liver. At one point, they will affect the health of the body and cause serious diseases. Patients with cancer and other chronic illnesses have more stones than healthy individuals. Gallstones form in both the liver's bile ducts and the gallbladder. Most stones start in the liver and few occur in the gallbladder. Gallstones are soft or hard stones that only form in gall. They consist of cholesterol, salt, or bilirubin. Gallstones range in size. Some can be as small as a grain of sand or as large as an apricot. 80% of gallstones are cholesterol. The other 20% consists of calcium salts and bilirubin. Gallstones may contain bile salts, water, mucus, toxins, bacteria, and sometimes dead parasites. Calcified gallstones in the gallbladder are for the most part made of calcified bilirubin. They can be light brown or black or other colors. Brown stones contain more cholesterol and calcium than black stones. There are many different reasons why gallstones form in the body. The most common cause is our bad eating habits. Food high in cholesterol is the primary culprit for the development of gallstones. These foods include animal products like red meats, poultry, fish, and dairy products. Humans can't digest meat and dairy properly. We are in fact plant eaters. The human intestine is long and coiled, much like that of apes, cows, and horses. Our digestion is slow and allows time to break down and absorb the nutrients from plants. The intestine of a carnivore like a cat is short, straight, and tubular. A carnivore's liver has unlimited capacity to process cholesterol. Humans, like other plant-eating animals, have organs with limited capabilities for cholesterol removal. We have evolved on plant foods and never required a cholesterol-eliminating system. Medicine, drugs, and birth control pills also increase the risk of developing gallstones. Pharmaceutical drugs are taxing for the liver. All pharmaceutical drugs suppress the natural functions of the body. They don't heal the underlying cause of the disease. Instead, drugs make the liver work on overdrive to remove the poisons from the body. A stressful lifestyle can alter the natural flora of the bile and create gallstones in the liver. Severe stress affects the digestive system and the flow of digestive juices. Undigested food wrecks the liver and gallbladder and other organs. You can cleanse your liver with a liver and gallbladder cleanse. It's a natural method of removing gallstones from the liver. You can do the cleanse from your home without any side effects if you follow the protocol to the letter. Alcohol use can cause several types of cancer, including liver cancer. When you drink alcohol, the liver has to remove the poisons from the body. Regular heavy alcohol use can damage the liver, leading to inflammation and scarring. Herbicides and chemicals such as arsenic can also increase the risk of liver cancer. The liver detoxifies the body, creates bile, helps the digestion, and much more. Liver cancer begins in hepatocyte cells and the bile ducts. Every cancer has a distinct config shock that activates a particular biological program. The biological conflict linked to hepatocellular carcinoma is a starvation conflict. Bile duct cancer is a male territorial anger conflict or a female identity conflict. Gallstones and alcohol abuse may also cause liver cancer. If you fix these things, you may have a higher chance of reversing liver cancer. Download our free liver cancer healing protocol to learn how to treat liver cancer with natural remedies. There are more ways you can prevent liver cancer without using toxic cancer treatments. The link to this document is in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, then press the like button and subscribe to the channel. Share this video on social media with all your friends and families. Please visit our blog at cancerwisdom.net to learn non-toxic ways to treat cancer. You can also download more free documents in our free resource library and learn other ways to prevent cancer. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.